Guess you gotta peel it first. The video camera on. I'm not ready yet.
Well, it's been a while since I made a video. We have probably had the wettest winter, if not the wettest, one of the wettest winters I've ever seen since I've been here. Just constant gale force, wind and rain, starting about mid-October through April. It's now, 7th or 8th of May. Whew! Man, what a miserable winter. Most of my videos are about new guns, just looking at new guns I buy. I haven't bought a gun in a year and a half, except one, which I still have not shot yet, and I'll do a video on sometime this summer. But today I thought I'd go back a few years and shoot something I haven't been able to find on YouTube. Nobody's had one. They've had stuff fairly close, but this is the first gun I ever own. It's Bolt Action 22, and my father bought it for me probably when I was born. I'm not sure they had the capability to look into the, to tell if it was going to be a boy or a girl at the time. So anyway, this gun was probably made right around 1946. Let me come up a little closer. It's a Stevens Model 52C. There is no serial number on it, as they weren't required back then. But if you take the stock off on the barrel under here, it is professionally engraved the family name. So that becomes my serial number. There's really nothing, you know, difficult about this. This one screw here takes the stock off. Metal trigger guard stays with the stock, or you can take it off with these little screws right here. It's got a 5-round magazine. And of course, bolt action. So I just thought I'd bring this out for anyone who's really curious about these old guns. Kind of a hard plastic butt plate. It's got dings and scratches. I shot the holy crud out of this thing when I was 14, 15, before we moved someplace where I just couldn't even have a gun. So, and I haven't shot it for a few years. I'll break down if you want to do a field strip. Pull a trigger, pull a bolt out. Reverse the same. So let's go take a few shots. I'm going to be shooting this target grade performance from Federal. I bought a whole bunch of these boxes. Every time I could find it, I bought it. Because when, 2012, after that school shooting, 22 became pretty rare, rarer than gold. And I opened the boxes to see how this was working before I bought a lot of it. Worked fine, but I can't find the open box. So, we'll open a box. Let me put some rounds in the magazine, reposition the camera, and take a few shots. What an open box of this ammo looks like. If you're curious, 325 rounds in there. Not going for any distance shooting here. Just want a shooter. I broke the sights off of this thing years and years ago. I couldn't believe some of the things I could hit and the distances I could hit them at. But once I broke the sights, and replaced them. I just never seem to be able to get her sighted in again. She loads pretty easy. There is seems to be less recoil and less noise. Well, it's definitely less noise with this. So it has a 26-inch barrel versus my 1022, which has an 18-inch barrel, I think. So that 1022 is really loud. This thing's really soft. It's almost like shooting a pellet BB gun. Probably didn't even need my headset. But that's it for this video. Just a short, quick, and dirty video. Just so I can get something up. Let people know I'm still alive.
Here it is, alongside a 1022 for reference. I got the chambers lined up here. You see it's a little bit longer. Old. Reasonably new. Oh, I'm losing my sunlight. Anyway. Life's a blast.